John here, guys, and today we're talking about the full build-up and review of the Hyperlow Airshot, and I'm pairing this with these brand new Zing version 2 motors. This is the giant size 2506 1650 kV. These motors are super powerful for a 5-inch, but you could just as easily use them on a 6-inch, no problem. This frame flies through the air with the greatest of ease. It did come up a little bit heavy, but man, that extra weight with the power to toss it around feels so fun in the air. It takes you back to those original days of freestyle where you had a lot of weight and a lot of power, but it gives it a modern day power spin to it. You never had this amount of power back in the day. Now you do. The rest of the build, I'm rounding this out with the Caddx Vista with the Mamba 30x30 stack with a 40 amp ESC, and it just flies like a dream. The really thin arms allow you to just carve through the air. It's very smooth, even on stock Betaflight 4.2. This thing absolutely has the power to carry a full-size camera. I'm flying it around on the GoPro Hero 9, and honestly, these motors are a little bit overkill. So if I were to build this up again, I might go with a little bit smaller motor. Even a 2207 would work. This does come up a little bit heavy though, so the extra juice in these motors is a welcome addition, but at times it's a little bit difficult to control the size of these things at low speeds. Certain times I almost thought my quad was just having an issue where it was shooting up in the air, and it was like, no, the sticks were very sensitive at low speeds, so I would probably want to put a little bit of expo to keep the center of the stick a little bit more tame. But when you want to get up in the air, man, this thing tosses you up very nice. Now, this is not a super tall motor, so the absolute top end is not quite as fast as some of your other more standard size motors, but that middle and low range, my goodness, it just feels incredible. It just soars through the air. This kind of was a lot of what I was expecting. I thought I was going to get really smooth flight because of the reduced air resistance. That's right, the Hyperlow uses these thin size arms, so it just absolutely carves through the air. There's not a lot blocking the airflow and creating wind resistance like you have on a lot of other frames. Now, the center is very, very long. I do like that for this size quad because the GoPro is going to be taking up some room at the front, so you still have plenty of room at the back. It comes with a cutout battery pad that's made from Uma Grip, which is a really nice touch as well. There are a variety of GoPro mounts for this frame. This is the universal style at the front. There's also one that can go on the rear so that you can have like sort of a chase camera with the camera facing backwards. If you could fly in front of something, get that rear view right there. There's also a lot of mounting options for your Vista. There is one that's made for this that can also hold a GPS, but since the little hole was right there, I just kind of tied it on there just to do a quick and dirty. I actually like this pretty well. There is a nice Immortal T Crossfire antenna holder at the front. There is a ton of beef all along the bottom here because of the way that these arms lock together. You have a few different layers on the bottom, so the strength of this frame and the bottom section is very, very tight. You actually end up, because you have this very thick carbon fiber bumper at the front, you end up getting a lot of protection at the front as well. If there's any weak point, it may be the top plate, but it's as long as you're not crashing upside down from 100 feet up, I don't think you're gonna have to worry about this either. So this frame really gives you a mix of very interesting flight characteristics, very interesting styling. One of the things I like the best are the floss style arms. There's also these motor protectors that I printed on a Thingiverse that extend that arm protection even further. Running a super wide motor like this, 25 millimeter diameter motor, you don't want to go banging those things up because it is a lot wider than your average motor, but this frame is going to be the one you're going to want to do it with because it has just about the most motor protection of any frame like this out there. So this is a specialized type thing. If you want really low wind resistance, if you're not really going to be bando bashing, because I don't think that this is for that, but you want protection in case you do have to crash. If you wanted something that was gonna be used for actual cinema type gigs, this thing flies very smooth and has a lot of beefy protection to keep everything protected for you in the universal GoPro mount that you can easily take on and off your camera very quickly. Nice job on this Hyperlow, and really interesting motor on these. The bell design on these Zing 2s is absolutely fantastic. It's very thick, it's a unibody construction, and I like the new design. They formerly had those painted kind of designs that they're very popular, but it just wasn't my thing. I actually like this quite a bit more. It almost looks like a sports car rim. Really nice. Thanks, guys.
That was pretty smooth. Motors are nice and cool. That was with the Hero 9. Man, this thing is very smooth, man.